Hi everybody, welcome back to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. Today we'll be doing accuracy test of the GPS and heart rate accuracy between the COROS PACE 2 and the Amazfit GTR2e. So without further ado, let's get into it.
If you're new to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way.
Now let me tell you about the test rules. So basically, I was walking down from Hammersmith Bridge all the way down to Putney Bridge. The distance there is about 2.6, 2.7 kilometers, somewhere around there. But I was actually tracking the distance with my Samsung S10 Plus on the Polar Beat app, and it has shown me a distance of 2.61 kilometers. Now, the heart rate benchmark will be performed by the Polar H10 ECG chest strap, which was across my chest all the time during this walk. So let me quickly tell you about the two sport and smartwatches we've got in front of us today and why I've chosen them in particular. So first of all, the COROS PACE 2, this is a full-on sport watch. It's got training guides, it's got training program, it's got dual inbuilt GPS, it's got an always-on display. This is a sport watch from the COROS brand, and it's actually the only sport watch under $200. And this is a true competitor to Garmin sport watches. Now, I actually brought along the Amazfit GTR2e for a reason. So this is a smartwatch, but we've had a lot of problems with GPS accuracy as well as heart rate accuracy from the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the GTR2e previously. But we've been told that Amazfit has actually updated its firmware on the GTR2e as well as the GTS2e, and it has improved the GPS accuracy as well as the heart rate measurement accuracy, and we are going to check that. So the Amazfit GTR2e, this is a 1.39 inch AMOLED display, looks absolutely amazing, a 30-day battery, inbuilt GPS, water resistant, it's got it all apparently. But let's see if it's got the accuracy. So first, let's look at the GPS. So as we can see on the screen right now, we can see that the Samsung S10 has actually measured a distance of 2.61 kilometers. Let's have a look what the COROS PACE 2 came up with. We can see that it shows us a distance of 2.51 kilometers. So that is off by just under 4%, by just 3.8%. Now, let's take a look at what the GTS2e has come up with. 2.95 kilometers. That's off by 12%. Well, just under 12%, but that is absolutely massive. So, of course, if previously the differences were as much as 20%, now we're down to 12%. An improvement? Definitely. But is the result spot on? No, not yet. But that's fine. Let's take a look at the heart rate accuracy next. Okay, so with heart rate accuracy, we can also see that the Polar H10 ECG chest strap has actually come up with two values. So the average was 102 beats per minute over the walk, while the max was registered at 115 beats per minute. Let's take a look at what the COROS PACE 2 has actually come up with. So this is the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the COROS PACE 2. And we can see that the average was spot on, also 102 beats per minute, while the max was understated by 2 beats per minute at 113. So this is quite amazing. So at one point the max was not registered, so the peak was off slightly, but the average is spot on. And this is over 35 minutes of walking, so there are quite a few data points on there. Let's take a look at what the Amazfit GTR2e has come up with. So this particular test is actually quite easy for the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the smartwatch, because this is a low intensity activity. So this is where the heart rate is rather stable across a period of time. It's just walking, it's not running. And let's look at the result. So the result shows us that the average heart rate was measured at 105 beats per minute, while the max was registered at 121 beats per minute. That is off. So we are saying it's not massively off, but it's 3 beats per minute higher on the average, and it's 6 beats per minute higher on the max. showing us that yes, even though the heart rate accuracy was improved, GPS accuracy has also been improved, we can still see that it's still out quite significantly. Anyways, thank you for watching this GPS and heart rate accuracy test review and comparison of the COROS PACE 2 as well as the Amazfit GTR2e. Hopefully you did find this useful. If you did, please drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, you know what to do. Please click the red subscribe button below the video, and we'll see you in the next one.